It's my great pleasure to introduce Garrett Benjamin.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm told it's been 27 years of pancake breakfast, anyway, supporting the Akron Youth Symphony. All right, so this is for those of you who don't know, this is my second incarnation as director of the Akron Youth Symphony. Mike remembers back when it was back in the 90s, and we were 20 years younger, 25 years younger, and I had been teaching high school in Newton, Massachusetts, and I had gone to graduate school to study conducting, which was the thing I really wanted to be doing, although I loved teaching high school, I loved conducting a high school orchestra, but I really wanted to have some place to be able to reach more people in the audience and in an orchestra. And so I started taking auditions. This was in the old days before the internet. So you were sending out paper through the mail, and I stood in line, I didn't think I was gonna talk about this, but I'm gonna talk about it. I stood in line at the post office in Newtonville, Massachusetts on a February evening, probably, just like this February evening. And it was 5 o'clock, and as usual, I procrastinated about getting my application in for this position as assistant conductor with the Akron Symphony Orchestra, which I thought was in Iowa. and so I stood in line at this little post office in Newtonville, Massachusetts, and I was kicking myself because, as usual, I procrastinated, and the due date for these materials was tomorrow, and here I am standing yet again at the end of the business day and waiting in line. There were about 12 people ahead of me. And it's going to cost me, I'm going to have to overnight this, it's going to cost me about 30-something dollars, which instead of, you know, the usual rate, what was it back then, 2.25 or something. And I was just upbraiding myself for being so lax about this. Why the way I was living like this? And so I looked at this, and I said, I'm going to get a rejection letter or no response at all. Why am I doing this? This is 30 bucks I could put to something else. Diapers. And not for me, for my son. And then I stepped away from the line, and there was somebody standing there at the door. It was closing time. They were standing at the door, and so he saw me coming, so he unlocked the door, waiting for me, and I walked up to him, and I stopped looking at this package that was going to go off to Akron. Oh, Ohio. Akron, Ohio. Oh, I love that. And then I realized, of course, that you can't win if you don't play. So I got back in line. The guy looked at me, locked the door, and I waited in line for my 12 people in front of me to go through. And then I sent my application materials to Akron, Ohio, to be assistant conductor of the Akron Symphony and to conduct the Akron Youth Symphony. And then I forgot about it for months until the phone rang, and it was Connie Linsler. Remember Connie Linsler? Some of you. Connie was the general manager of the orchestra, who invited me to come to Akron for an audition. I came. I was one of five people that came to audition, and lo and behold, they hired me. And I conducted the Akron Youth Symphony in a rehearsal, and had a wonderful time. It was on the strength, I think, probably mostly of my conducting the kids that they hired me. I worked with professionals. I was new at this, so I had to learn a lot about conducting professional musicians. But conducting kids, I knew about, because I worked on this for years. Working especially at the high school level, and I found out that classical music, that symphonic music with kids, does sell. As long as they're doing it. If you're trying to get them to go sit in the hall and listen, that's another thing, isn't it, Peter? We know that. Yeah, it's tough. Although I've got to say, this Akron Youth Symphony that I'm working with this year has a very substantial representation of kids that go to the concerts, the Akron Symphony concerts. For one thing, I think the orchestra and its management have made a concerted effort to make sure that the kids and their parents feel very welcome. And so that there's a linkage there that did not used to really quite exist. So the kids, I've found that they love symphony music because they can do it. That's the beginning. But there are kids who will then go on and will take advantage of the ticket offer and go to hear the Akron Symphony as well. But what do I find so exciting, as Peter mentioned? Well, first of all, there's the literature itself. I fell in love with orchestra music when I was sixth grade. I was in the sixth grade. There was no orchestra where I grew up. I grew up in St. Albans, Vermont, which is roughly equivalent to about Dover, Ohio, Dover or New Philadelphia, which is also where I conduct the Tuscarora Philharmonic. But St. Albans, Vermont, and those towns are very similar, except they have a symphony orchestra resident. That's the Tuscarora Philharmonic, which I also conduct. St. Albans, Vermont has none of that. We have a town band and some church choirs, and of course the school band. But for me, there's something exotic and very powerful about symphony orchestra music. Band music was fine, choral music was wonderful, but there was something about the symphony orchestra literature that for me also, though, was a forbidden territory, because there was none close by. Had I known that there were places like Akron, Ohio, I thought the symphony orchestras were things that inhabited places like Boston only, or New York, or Philadelphia. Here's Akron, Ohio with the symphony orchestra. And then not just that, ladies and gentlemen, but a youth symphony as well, where kids are getting firsthand experience of playing some of the great masterworks. Kids can actually play Beethoven's Fifth. They actually let them play Beethoven's Fifth Symphony. And not only that, but they have a ball doing it, and they get this great intensity. That piece rocks, as they would say. So I love being around people who have that kind of response to a piece of classical music. It's the same response I have. Now, I also, as a conductor, though, one of the things I get to do, well, I'll go to another anecdote. Why do I conduct young people? It's fun. I had the pleasure, Christopher Wilkins, our music director of the Akron Symphony, and I are the next to the last generation. There are people 20 years younger than we are who had the benefit of instruction with Leonard Bernstein. And I was at Tanglewood one summer, and Bernstein was had running the master class, and so I was in the master class. And here's what Leonard Bernstein said about conducting and about music. At one point, he was watching another guy in the master class conduct, and this guy was being very careful to mind his P's and Q's. He was going to do it correct for Leonard Bernstein. Bernstein watched this for a while, and he jumped out of his chair, and he said, "It's got to be fun. It's got to be fun." And then he went on to talk about, what do I mean by fun? All the things that you think of when kids think about fun. It's got to be funny. There's got to be humor. There's got to be energy. There's got to be passion. There's got to be... He named a bunch of things. He named a whole list of things. And in the end, he said, actually, it's got to be the opposite of boring. Anything. So he says, so in that respect, the Verdi Requiem, or Mozart's Requiem, can be fun, even though it's about death. It's because it's about being, about not being bored. And so my job as an orchestra conductor then is I get the great pleasure of going in and trying to make it making it fun for kids to sit in a rehearsal for 3.5 hours on a Sunday afternoon, every Sunday afternoon. And I get to do that by sharing with them something that got lit in me, a fire about orchestra music particularly. Only the big difference is I didn't have the opportunity to play in an orchestra. In Vermont, there was only one youth orchestra in the whole state when I was growing up. And I didn't have that opportunity. But they do, because they live here in the area of Akron, Ohio, which now for the better part of a century has had a youth symphony orchestra as part of its mission, the Great American Musical Association. And it also because of the support of folks like you and West Akron Kiwanis, who have made sure that this opportunity is there for kids to have this direct contact, to touch the third rail of art and play orchestra music with the kind of, and then I get to just sort of help shape that energy. Oh, there are a couple of kids, you know how kids are, right? There are a lot of them are studied nonchalance. So when you can get one of those kids so that their eyes light up, it doesn't take much, especially you choose the right music, and their eyes light up. And then there is the kid, and we've got several of them too, who have just got so much energy, so much interest. They are so active, and so it's just a matter for me then to have the pleasure of channeling that. But I just got to finish by telling you one story about one of the things that I remember from my first time with the Akron Youth Symphony. Back in through the 90s, was a very quiet girl who was, again, as I say, sort of studied nonchalance about things. And she wasn't being coy, she just was very quiet. And I wish I could play it for you here. I was playing a piece by Ottorino Respighi, the Italian composer, who took some 16th century dance music for lute and transcribed it for orchestra. It's one of the things I love about symphony music. It takes you back. It takes you around the world. It takes you, it's not pop music, which is every time, it's, you know, pop music is all about here and now. But, and in the oldies, 1954, that's me. But no, we've got symphony orchestra music, of course, that can take you back 500 years into an entirely different culture. Okay, so here is Ottorino Respighi orchestrating lute music from the 16th century, and one of the pieces, I wish I could play it for you, I wish I had a piano here. In our first reading, our first rehearsal, I was conducting along, and I looked down at this girl. She had red hair, she was playing along the violin, and there was a tear. And then I knew that I picked the right piece of music that was going to engage this kid, engage, in fact, the whole room. You know, the whole hall of us loved it. But that one girl, I got it. And so finding that moment where a piece of music connects with somebody, and of course we interpret tears, it moved me to tears. It's the highest praise we give about something, right? You think about that sometime. But she was touched, and that moment, or the moment when the kid's eyes light up as we play a Mozart piece, or just when I mention the mere possibility that we'll play Beethoven's Fifth. Yeah. Okay, well then, we all want something to look forward to, so that tomorrow is not simply another day occupying a square on a calendar and with a number on it. It's something that gives something special about the future, something special about tomorrow, something special about the next day. And classical music and symphonic music played in the context of something like the Akron Youth Symphony can do that, can turn that square with a number in it into an experience that makes life worth living. So, all right, that's those are the big overarching pictures. But the get down to the nitty gritty, it's making it fun, making it engaging, and to play symphonic music in the context of the Akron Youth Symphony Orchestra. I could go on that, ladies and gentlemen, but I better stop there. I think you got the idea. So, if there's any questions, I'd love to talk some more. A question for me about Akron Youth Symphony or Great Rank Music Association, I think I can still answer those. Yeah?
I know that the students that get accepted have to audition.
Right.
How tough is the competition?
Well, there are a lot of youth symphony orchestras around, actually. Now, when I first got here in 91, the shutter that had gone through Great Record Musical Association is the Cleveland Orchestra has started a youth symphony. And the Cleveland competition was on yet again for Akron, Ohio, right? So you ask how tough it is. We ask the kids to play a certain, to prepare a certain repertoire and to come in. I've got to tell you that right now the orchestra is generally more proficient than it was back when I was with it in the 90s. Just we're drawing from a deeper pool of talent, I think. So even with the competition we're getting from Canton and from up north, the Akron Youth Symphony, the way it is configured right now, Chris Wilkins says along with me, he's gone up and conducted quite, you know, the Cleveland Orchestra Youth Orchestra. The caliber of the Akron Youth Symphony is very strong right now. So the audition we can be kind of stringent because the pool is there, especially with string players. And we do the auditions in May in preparation for the following season. Yeah.
How old is your youngest musician?
Oh.
What do they play?
Oh, you've got to come here. When's the April concert? When's the last concert? June or May?
It's in May. Yeah.
In May.
Yeah.
Well, you go online, you find out, because we've got an eighth grader who is, and she's petite. She's from Japanese heritage, right? Yeah, that's right. Yeah, and she's going to play the first movement of the Brooke Violin Concerto. So she's an eighth grader. I think there might be a seventh grader, again playing strings. We do have, of course, the Akron Youth Philharmonic that provides a preparatory experience for the kids before they come into the Akron Youth Symphony, under the direction of Douglas Bida, who's in the Akron's public school system. And they are going to be performing with the Akron Youth Symphony in a side-by-side concert on Sunday, March 19th, right, the 26th, my concert runs up. 3 weeks. All right, so Sunday afternoon, you can get two for the price of one. Akron Youth Philharmonic and Akron Youth Symphony at 3 o'clock at Talmadge High School, right? The Talmadge High School is where we're performing. So the Youth Philharmonic keeps the younger kids generally, but we do occasionally accept some young kids, even seventh graders, who come in.
When we have our pancake breakfast, the performers, I think I counted 8 counties that they come from.
Yeah.
Really big, and they all seem to be, at least the ones that perform there, are just regular middle-class kids.
Yeah, yeah. A lot. No, it's not big money. And we do offer scholarship money for lesson subsidies, as you will know, and some other scholarship funding as well, on the basis of merit and as well based on need. Some of these kids come from families that were ill, private lessons, especially when they got a family of four all taking private lessons, then we certainly want to support that. So that's where some of your funding, some of your support goes, is to make sure that kids can get the training. When I moved here from the West Coast, East Coast, that's over that way, yeah, right, from the Boston area, you know, we were pretty hoity-toity about what you could get in Boston for experience. We had a couple of different youth orchestras, and we had, of course, the Boston Symphony, la da da. And then when I came here and found what there is for a musical culture that is growing right here in Akron and in the greater Akron area, you're right, it's widespread. And again, the Akron Youth Symphony, though, gets to serve sort of as a magnet, a mark for this particular market, and give these kids this kind of opportunity. And I'm a very happy man that I get this shot once again to work with the Akron Youth Symphony and to enjoy the fellowship of West Akron and support of West Akron Kiwanis. Yes?
So I have a 5-year-old son and a 7-year-old son.
That's a little young for me, but okay.
I'll play them, music from the famous composer.
Yeah.
Really love John Williams.
Yeah, sure.
So,
they
ask me how great he is. What do I say? How do I compare him?
He's wonderful. It's music that's fun to listen to by itself, but it tends to be music that's about that image on the screen, of course, although he writes so well because it is fun to listen to by itself, too. So, we don't need to make comparisons. We can love it all. You can love Johann Sebastian Bach, and yeah, I got a kick out. One of my favorite pieces to conduct is Raiders of the Lost Ark. The Tuscarora Philharmonic board bought it for me as long as I promised to use it a lot. So we played at Christmas. John Williams is wonderful, and he's a great place to start for many of us. Now, the sound of a symphony orchestra is the sound we hear in Star Wars, and he sort of gave new birth to the symphony orchestra in our lifetime by writing so imaginatively for it, and with these films that, of course, I've done very, very, very well. So, thank you for the reminder. I'm going to drop some John Williams on the Akron Youth Symphony because it's fun to play, too. Yeah. All right, I think that'll be it. Thank you very much.